What's going on, people? It's your boy DJ, part of the NFC South versus the NFL. Also going to be the host of the Buck Stops Here. And I'm here with my boy Mike.
You know what it is. It's your boy Mike Ricks, man, host of the Mike Ricks podcast. Also, the Carolina Panthers representative of the NFC South versus the NFL. And like we start every video, yes, do your boys a favor.
Please.
All it takes is 3 clicks, 5 seconds. Yippity. Click, click, click. On that like button, that subscribe button, and that notification bell so you can get all the alerts for anytime we drop any content. DJ.
All the alerts, baby.
DJ, it's May. It's May 2021. The draft has been completed. We're days away from OTAs and the schedule release, but we're going to go ahead and do the way too early, right? Way too early predictions on who we think is going to come out of the South and our placements and all of that. You ready for it, man?
It's the way too early, baby. I appreciate if y'all checked out the rest of the series where we talked about every single team in this division. If you haven't already, please go back and check that. Pause this video and then come back to this video because we're going to get into it. And let's go. Way too early, Mike. Yeah. Oh, man. So we're going to see a lot of shakeup, in my opinion, in this division. Something that's been pretty new. You know, for the most part, the Saints have been the runners of this division. The runners, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers over the last 10 years have probably been the team that's been the fourth team majority. And then the Carolina Panthers, Atlanta Falcons, just they be seesawing. It seems like they've been seesawing. And lately they've been kind of now a little down. Tampa Bay's now rising, won a Super Bowl. New Orleans Saints begin to the playoffs, but it seems like there's always something happening and they're blaming everybody else but their own damn team.
Facts. Bow, 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 bow. Boy, he's shooting at y'all, man.
Man, because I mean, look, I've been crying. I've been paying attention now. I've been paying attention. Like, yo, TJ, I love you to death. If you ain't checking, I know you're gonna check it out. But y'all gotta stop this shit. But you're leading Drew Brees is going now, or the crybaby committee. So maybe I might change it, you know. The story, but what's your feeling with this division after we broke down all these videos of what we're seeing in this division? Where do you see some shakeup? Do you see the Saints still being on top? Where we at?
Well, yeah, I'm glad you asked this. It's actually what I felt right after the draft. Going deeper into it, I still feel the exact same way. I'm gonna say Atlanta's gonna be the bottom of this division at 4. And I'm going to say it's going to be a close battle between the Saints and Carolina. But I think the Saints will finish third, miss the playoffs, and Carolina will get their wild card spot. And Tampa Bay will win the division. That's the route I'm going. But the thing that scares me a little bit about New Orleans is that they've been in situations where it seems like they should be out. They've been down. They've had injuries, whatever the case may be. But they still find ways to win football games. So I don't know if that was the level of just Sean Payton and Drew Brees, the chemistry they had together, or if it's just John Payton. We're going to find out very soon. But I really just like the makeup of this Carolina Panther football team. I love the makeup of Tampa Bay and their consistency of bringing everybody back with their experience. And it seems like those other two teams are – they're finding themselves again. I don't know. They got new coaches there. They got a new leader as a quarterback. We do too, but they seem like they have more pieces missing than the Saints. I don't know, DJ. It just seems like that's the way this division is shifting. So what's your thoughts, my brother? What's your thoughts on it?
Makes a lot of sense, Mike. Makes a lot of sense that I see where you go there with that. Hey, I'm not mad at it, right? We looked at this. We've been breaking this down. It makes a lot of sense. Our 4 is definitely going to match. Look, Atlanta Falcons, new head coach. That record for head coaches, I mentioned in your video, is not pretty. It's not pretty at all. He's going to have his struggles. A lot of inexperience on that coaching staff. And on top of that, they are filling a roster that was kind of depleted prior, you know, post Dan Quinn. You got your question with Julio Jones, you know, what's going on there. It's a year that you guys are going to take some lumps and bumps and y'all going to be fourth in this division. You're probably going to be picking in the top 10 again. And that's just what it's going to play out to be. My number 3 team is going to be the Carolina Panthers as of right now. I'm not ready to put them where I kind of want to from a roster standpoint. There's an argument there that you really honestly can say the Carolina Panthers might have one of the stronger, you know, rosters. You can put the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, which you're guessing I'm going to put in the division lead this, way too early. But the one thing that's I may mention in the video I'm questioning is the coaching staff. And I think that's where I'm going to give the edge to the Saints. And then also, I will think that I'm looking at it, like I might be a little homer because he's already played for the, I think Jameis Winston right now is still better than Sam Darnold. So you put those two things together. I have the Saints currently going to be the second team, and I think that's how it's going to shake out. But with me being saying that, because if you watch the video about Carolina Panthers, I still think you got a chance to make the playoffs, especially with the 17-game roster. I mean, it's a schedule. So just because they're coming in third don't mean they don't have a chance to the playoff spot, Mike. So that's what I'm looking at.
Very true. Very, very true. And that's fair, man. That's fair. There's nothing you said that I can't, go back and forth with. That's a fair assessment. Atlanta, I know y'all are going to think we're hating.
They're going to kill us. God damn.
Y'all did the same thing to us last year, and we hit it on the nail again. We told you Dan Quinn was going to get fired. We told you were going to start off 0-5, 0-6, something like that. We knew that was going to happen. We saw all of this, and y'all still came and bashed us at the beginning of the season. If you need me to pull tape, damn it, I'll pull it. But I'm telling you, it's nothing personal. We have to look at this at an unbiased eye and just looking at the new coach, your roster, your deficits, your money cap situation, how you going to figure out what you're going to do.
There's so much that team.
There's a lot going on, man.
There's so much with that team. We're going to come back with more videos about the Atlanta Falcons because there's a dynamic with that team that we haven't hit on any of the videos yet. Like I said, it's not hate. It's being honest. I mean, I hope you guys are being honest. I feel like there might be an honesty going on with that team, and like I said, we're gonna break this down a little more because, like I said, they've been a team we've been beating up since I think we started doing this thing, especially me. I've been killing them. But I feel like it's been warranted. You guys are very intriguing at this point. And like I said, look out for the videos. Let us know, Carolina Panthers, Bucs, the Saints, and the Falcons. Let us know what you think. Do you like my rating? Do you like Mike's rating? Do you have your own damn ring? You think the Falcons gonna win the division? Hey, I've been seeing it all over the goddamn place. Yeah. Apparently, y'all gonna be competing for the damn division. I'm not oblivious to what's being said out here. I just currently cannot see it. And hopefully we can get one of the Atlanta Falcon commentators that we've been kind of trying to reach out to and trying to get on here. We plan on doing that for every team, even my own team. And we're gonna try to have some dialogue about these teams. But as of right now, this is what Mike and me think. So let us know what y'all think.
Yes, definitely put it in the comments. You can put it in your order. If you don't agree with us, you can just say, I agree with DJ, I'd agree with Mike, whatever you want to do. Just make sure you hit that.
Or damn both y'all, this what the fuck is going to be.
Put your own in there. Do that.
Shoot.
In facts. But anyway, man, this your boy Mike Ricks, man, host of the Mike Ricks Podcast. Also, your Carolina Panthers representative. It's been fun. It's been extremely fun.
Series been fun, Mike. I enjoyed this.
Yeah, DJ, this has been a nice series, man. So make sure if you haven't checked out the beginning part of it or all of them, make sure you go back and click. They're all together on the playlist too. So
happy
make sure
it's
you
over.
Do that. Yeah, that's right. But anyway, man, DJ, you got anything you want to say? Last words?
Yeah, that's it, man. Come at me. I like bow bow bullets all day, baby. When you're the defending Super Bowl champ, I don't give up. Yeah. But anyway, this your boy DJ.
That's a little pistol starter.
This your boy DJ. Part of the future. Buck stops here. And hopefully, that's what I'm about, man. We've been doing this all week. It's supposed to be done like back to back in a minute. But we appreciate all the love, support, and everything. It's been a lot coming through. Really, really, really do appreciate it. And keep it coming, man. Just keep it coming. We'll come up with the content. If y'all want to hear us talk about something or you see another series that y'all want us to break down, hey, throw it in the comments. Let us know. Thanks. We open to everything. We got more coming. We got lists. I got my goddamn notepad next to me. We going to get it. Let's go, Mike. Season is on its way. OTA is not that far away.
That's right. Yes, sir. NFC South versus the NFL. Thank y'all again, and we out. Peace.